Since I've given myself over to the devil, I mean to savor the world and its many delights, so long as I may. But I would like to know what's keeping my family so long. He should have done my errands and returned long ago. Ah, there. He's coming now.
Your Magnificence, I have executed all your commissions.
Good, dear Wagner.
But why haven't you hired a boy for which you got my permission? Have you found no one suitable yet?
Oh, yes, Your Magnificence. If you wish, I shall introduce you to him at once.
Where is he, then?
Oh, he's in my room. He is fresh from his travels, and he begged me for something to eat and drink. I shall call him at once. My friend!
What?
Please come here at once. His Magnificence wants to speak with you.
Just a minute. Let me finish my neck of mutton first.
Please come at once.
Let me finish my drink at least.
Don't be so rude. Come right now.
Okay, I'm ready. So, what's the hurry? What's all the fuss that a body can't finish his meal in peace?
His Excellency would like to speak with you.
Oh, that's different. I'll pay him my compliments. Your insolence, my worthy respects, and it makes me uncommonly happy that you have the honor to make my acquaintance.
You have, I suppose, good testimonials to show?
Naturally. I have quite a gorgeous testimonial on my back.
Yes, Your Magnificence. He has assured me of that.
Oh, there's a place where I can make myself comfortable.
Very good.
Sapperment, this is as hard as nails.
Psst. My friend.
Well, now what?
Please, get up.
What for?
It is not fitting that you should be seated in His Magnificence's presence.
Oh, tough. I've just come from my travels, and when one's traveling, you need a rest. Beats me why Mr. Fabulous is making such a fuss. Your insolence hasn't said a thing while Brother Fabulous goes on and on about things that are none of his business. But just let me tell you, if you keep it up, I might lose my temper. Then, oh my God, help, help!
Listen, Mephistopheles, where to now? I can't stand it here in Wittenberg. Even if I had the wisdom of Solomon, yet no one here would believe it while I was still just a professor.
Go into your bedroom, Faust. There lies an almond sack filled with costly raiment and gems. Put them on, and people will take you for a prince. My flying cloak shall bear us to the instant to the Duke's of Parma's court, where his wedding festivities are being held. There, you may revel in delights and win glory with your mastery of the magic arts. And oh, love affairs shall not be lacking there either. Shall we take your servant along?
No, let Wagner stay here. He bores me.
But this Hanswurst.
Hanswurst. Yes, send him after me by some other means.
Now rejoice, Mephistopheles. At last I have the great man in my snare. For that my suffering shall be alleviated for 200 years. Other demons have already tried their luck with him, but in vain. Greed, pride, sloth, lust, all have been turned out of doors. For me alone was this happiness reserved, to draw him into the nets of hell. But he still has a servant named Hanswurst. He too must be devil's own.
This robe is splendid, Mephistopheles.
Thank you.
Now, I mean to see what your arts can accomplish. Mm-hmm. But let the journey proceed rather more slowly, so that I may admire the different architectural styles of the world. And if I go before the Duke, and he demands of me some demonstration, then bestir yourself. No matter what he demands to see, so that I may enhance my prestige. I'm leaving the housekeeping in Wagner's hands. As to Hans, he should follow me, but if by chance he should come before the Duke, he must not betray me or my arts, or he will be dismissed from my service. You know now my will. Obey it.
Yes, sir. You can rely entirely on me.
Yoo-hoo! Oops, my master isn't in here either. The devil knows where he's got to.
Tell me, what are you doing in my master's room?
Shut up, moon calf! My master has no other servant in the house besides Wagner and me.
And me.
Ah, who are you then?
Don't you know who I am, boy? Mm-mm. I am his head huntsman.
What use has the master for a head huntsman when he's a theologian?
Ah, but a great lover of the chase he is. I'm very much in favor with him too, you know. For I catch all the rabbits and foxes with my bare hands.
Oh, sapperment. You must be pretty sharp then. You'll save on gunpowder at any rate. What's your name?
Mephistopheles.
Mexatopheles.
Mephistopheles! Don't mangle my name, you
all
little...
All right. Don't get so upset. If you're in the service of our master, then tell me where he is.
He will have long since arrived in Parma.
Now I see that you're just a rascal. How can he be in
Parma? Parma is a dukedom, you moron. In Italy, where a grand nuptials is being celebrated.
Oh, then that's different. What are nuptials?
A nuptials is a wedding.
Is there going to be lots of food and drink?
Oh, Hansworth, to overflowing, as much as you like.
Oh, stomach rejoice! It's going to rain food again. Devil take me, but I'd sure like to go too.
Would you like to follow your master?
Yes, bring me to him.
But then you must give me what you have in your body.
Well, whatever I have in my body, you can have it. Only not until tomorrow, till my food's digested a bit.
Naughty boy. What do you mean by that? I'm talking about your soul.
Ah, but I don't have a soul because I'm made out of wood.
Then you must sign a document saying that you will be mine.
Oh, can't do it. I can't write.
Then you must swear that you will be mine.
Ha! I can swear that right now. It makes no difference to the authorities, and he has no witnesses. I can deny it all later. Now, as far as I'm concerned, I can promise you that right now.
Good, my boy. Then shake on it.
There. Oh, wow! Hot, hot, you carrion! You're as hot as a chimney burns just like a fire. What makes you so hot, anyway?
You know, we are all hot-tempered sorts.
You would be great to have around the house in winter. Wait till it's cold, and I'll just pop you in the oven.
No, it's not our business to keep people warm. Now, I'll send you a flying steed. But before that, I'll have to teach you the proper way to behave if you're going to go before the Duke. If you are asked whom you serve, you must, on no account, answer that you're in Dr. Faust's service. You would betray your master, and thus lose your job. And then, I'd have to break your neck. Understand?
Yes, certainly. Whoever doesn't understand that would have to have cotton in his ears. But I must go now and pack, so he'll get me something to ride on. I'm curious, though, to know whether Mexatopheles is going to get me a roan or a white horse. Then I'll ride like a lord through the streets and really impress the girls. Whoa! Now what the hell is that? Hey, help! Help, Topper, please! Is this the riding horse you promised me? Newfangled sort of horse. Sapperment. It's got fangs, too. Courage. I'll climb on. Well, that's not too uncomfortable. Whoa! What the devil? Slow down! Whoa! Slow down! I'll break my neck!
Please. Now, my dear Orestes, what say you to my choice of wife?
Oh, that you and the whole country must give thanks for having such a virtuous wife and first lady. Oh, and may heaven long grant us the felicity of being ruled by such a splendid royal couple.
Oh, whoa, you damn tailor's nag! I hope you explode!
Heavens!
What a catastrophe!
No castrati about it!
Your Highness, I am quite overcome. Who are you, my friend? Mm-hmm. How did you fall out of the sky without hurting yourself? Mm-hmm. He seems to be mute. And at the very moment, I think that he would have told us something. My friend, are you really dumb? Help me to understand by some sign how you got that way. How long have you been mute?
Oh, for a couple of minutes.
You scamp, you can speak as well as I.
Which goes to show you that I can be dumb and talk at the same time.
Very amazing introduction. Only tell me, my friend, did you take any harm from your fall?
If I broke an arm or leg, I'd just be off to the carpenter's and have him glue them together again.
Indeed?
Yeah, it's true.
Well then, stand up.
Listen, you might help me up?
I don't think I care to.
Well, in that case, I know what I'll do. I'll stand up myself. Oh, see, old man? Hands is still all in one piece.
Tell me, my friend, where do you come from?
I come from my fatherland.
And how does the ruler of your country sign his name?
With ink and paper.
I see I have a clever chap before me. But I'll outwit him yet. But you will tell me whether you are traveling on your own business or somebody else's.
No need to tell you I'm a servant. Just look at me.
Then tell me who your master is.
Oh, no. The knot sticks there. I can't give that away. Otherwise, my neck will be broken.
You can tell me anything. No harm will come to you.
Who are you really?
I am the Duke of Parma.
Who? The Fluke of Parma? Uh-oh, I'm about as welcome here as a pig in a Jew's house. Pardon me for not paying my respects yet. It pleases me greatly that you have the honor to make my acquaintance.
Very good, my friend, but now, will I be able to learn who your master is, or has he forbidden you to reveal that?
No, not my master, but Topperflees.
Topperflees? Who the devil is Topperflees? I never heard of him.
Shh, Mr. Duke. Gently, so he doesn't hear you. It is the devil.
Ha. I'm sure that's just a figure of speech. Now will you do as I say right away, or must I?
Mr. Duke, I'd like to, but I can't.
But you must. Speak quickly or...
Oh, wait. Hold on now. I've got an idea. Mr. Duke, can you answer a riddle?
Of course I can.
What's this?
That's an arm.
And what's at the very end of it?
A hand. And if you shut it, it becomes a fist.
Right! That's who I work for. But I didn't say it.
What? This... Faust? You're in the service of the great Dr. Faust?
Yes! I work for him! A fellow has to know how to talk to people without giving himself away. That's the main thing. I'm a real genius. I managed to get out of that. My skin's still in one piece.
You've been in the service of this great man. Have you learned any of his arts?
Oh, I taught him everything he knows.
You?
Sure. I am really Faust's teacher. Haven't you ever heard anything about my skill? My fame has already spread to the four corners of the earth.
No, I haven't heard anything about it.
Oh, now I remember. We just had such a hard winter that the news was frozen before it got here. But just wait till it thaws, then you'll really hear something.
I would be very eager to see something of your aunt's.
So, you want to see what I can do?
Yes.
Oh, then I'll satisfy your curiosity right away. See, Hans, if you had only learned something then, you could earn something now. Do you want to see something spectacular? Something flashy?
Yes, something really remarkable.
Would you like to see a great flood come pouring down and drown us all?
No, I don't want to see that.
It's a really terrific spell.
I'd rather you show me something else.
So, something else. Do you want to see a giant millstone fall out of the sky and drive us all 10 miles into the earth? Maybe? That's an impressive one.
You always suggest such stupid stuff.
Oh, stupid stuff! Can you do it then?
No.
Well, then, you mustn't call it stupid stuff, or you'll get my dander up. It really irritates me when anyone says it's stupid stuff when he can't even do it himself.
Don't be so fussy about it. Just show me another spell, something aesthetic.
Something pathetic. Now wait, I'll do a physical spell for you.
By a physical spell, what do you mean?
I'll produce smoke without fire or sulfur.
Now that must be wonderful. Let me see it at once.
Oh yes, it's terrific. It only takes a minute or two, and about a pound of beans. Now, stand to one side or you might get it in the face. Hocus pocus anus smokus!
Will it happen soon?
Right now, it's already on its way.
I'm very curious.
Oh, you'll be satisfied presently.
But I don't see anything yet.
I haven't seen anything yet either. I mean money.
It's really taking a long time.
Anything worthwhile takes time. Now, look out! Here it comes!
You filthy swine. Is that smoke without fire?
Sure, it's vapor without fire. Even though you can't see the fire, you can smell the fumes.
Rascal, to cheat me that way. Out of my sight, you beast.
Oh, well, how about some money?
Money? You should get a sound beating, you swine.
Oh, a beating? I could get that anywhere without your help. And I wouldn't have to travel too far to get it either.
Out of my sight. Wait, you damn scalawag. Orestes, go after him and grab him and have him punished for his trickery by cooling his heels in the guardhouse.
At once, Your Highness.
All happiness and good fortune attend you, Duchess. The joy of being with you is beyond measure, and I dare hope that you will grant me this delight for a long time.
Well, you are invited to join us for dinner tonight. Let us join the others at the castle. Follow me.
Your grace overwhelms me with kindness.
Change the subject. I see my husband coming. Most happily met, my husband.
Alone.
May my express wish be granted, Your Grace, that you and your wife dwell in eternal bliss and no misfortune cloud your joy.
I thank you.
My Lord Duke, you wish to send for me. What is your will?
How, Dr. Faust, can you divine my very thoughts?
How came you to divine my name, Your Grace?
Could the name of so famous a man remain secret for long? You're not the only master of the magic arts. I am myself a humble practitioner of them. It has long been my dearest wish to make your acquaintance. Now that I know, however, what a great master I have in my court, I must request something of you. The opportunity to view your famed skill, of which I have so often heard.
It is true that I am Dr. Faust. Does Your Grace perhaps wish an immediate demonstration of my art?
I accept your offer with great pleasure.
How may I serve you?
Ah, that famous Faust. Then you can certainly summon spirits from the dead.
I am capable of summoning anyone from any time or place at your command.
Now then, I should like to see the great giant Goliath and little David.
Oh, at once.
Mephistopheles,
Obey. Carry out my command.
Ah, truly splendid. The apparition exceeds my wishes. You are the greatest genius of the age.
Oh, I'm entirely of that opinion, Your Grace.
What does Your Highness desire to see next?
Would it be possible to see Samson and Delilah as she was cutting off his hair?
At once, noble Duchess.
Samson and Delilah in an embrace, burning with love.
But I don't see any scissors in her hand.
The spirits show these things as they were. It seems she did not betray him to the Philistines.
She resembles me, it seems. He is something of a rogue, this one. He sees himself as Samson now, and one can, of course, understand why the shoes wouldn't quite please him. Show us some new image.
Have you chosen one?
Oh, no. Choose for yourself. Spare me the trouble of making up my mind.
That is the heroic Judith, who crept into the enemy camp to betray the tyrant Holofernes with her caresses. She then offered him a sleeping potion and cut off his head, thus saving her city.
Wow, a deed of uncommon courage for a woman.
Judith is, as Delilah, entirely beautiful. Holofernes appears merely gruesome.
She chopped off his head, but that serves the rascal right.
They look like my husband and myself. What a bold stroke. In truth, this Faust is a good-looking. That is something to think about. Now I think I'll put his wit to the test. Lucrece was virtuous, and he will learn to treat me with more respect.
You have thought of another image?
Yes. Show us just one more. Can you now read my next wish in my eyes?
I have done all as you wished.
Oh, surely your magic art has not deserted you this time. Let us see the chaste Lucrece as she stabbed herself because someone wanted to deprive her of her virtue.
The images you saw have been more than mere smoke, but this time you have imagined what never existed. Lucretia may have existed, but never the chaste Lucrece.
Neatly parried. He has a respectable wit, and he represents virtue to me as a mere fiction. If the images we see are more than mere mist, then one can touch them without fear?
Well, there would be no point, gracious lady, in touching them.
Then I wish to see no more if I may not touch them.
The table is set. The guests await. The cook is ready to serve.
You must share the pleasures of our table, and I hope you may remain as a guest in our court for a long time to come. And after dinner, you will perhaps show us this or that trick.
If I can serve you in any way, it would be my good fortune.
Don't follow them!
Well, and why not?
Abandon the court. Flee! Flee as quickly as you can.
Why do you appear to me now?
Oh, if your life is dear to you, then follow my counsel.
Are you out of your mind? Why should I have to fear for my life?
You are in threefold danger. First, you have made the Duke jealous by flirting with his wife. For that, he will have you poisoned at dinner.
No doubt you know the antidote.
The highest clergymen are invited to the table. Therefore, you know I can only be present also.
Well, you're quite a hero. Now for the second reason.
Second, you're likely to be boiled in oil for the sin of heresy. You have called the Holy Scriptures a lie. Oh, the Inquisition will be hot upon your track.
First poisoned, then boiled. I can hardly wait to hear what follows.
With his Porlico and Porloco, your servant Hansworth has set all hell on its ear and the people into a state of turmoil. You, as his master, the people view as some sort of hedge wizard, a dangerous weather shifter, or well poisoner. The point is, they will join forces to get rid of you.
If the people, the spirit world, and the Duke are all against me, I must certainly yield. Arrange our escape. I do feel certain regrets, though, about leaving the Duchess behind. I think she will miss me.
I'll procure you empresses in compensation. We leave at once for Constantinople.
Fine, but leave Hanswurst here, so he can't play such pranks on me again. But make our ascent brilliant, so that the stupid peasants here will gape at my splendor.
I think I might arrange that.